there is so much fiction written about our epics. This struggle trying to understand where the truth lies, I had questions about what does it mean to be a Bharatiya or a Hindu that I call myself.
Something which is relevant 30 years ago is not relevant. How can it be relevant now?
This Mahabharat, there is a shloka which says, Ayat iha asti tad anyatra. Yat iha nasri asti na kutrajit. Ki whatever you find in Mahabharat, you will find it everywhere else. Whatever you don't find here, you will not find anywhere else. And Arjun is confused about what should I do. That's when Krishna is telling him the Bhagavad Gita, right? And in that, what is he saying? That to be able to take the right decision, you have to develop yogastha buddhi. It is the soul, the atma of Bhagavad Gita, right? Our entire life, personal and professional, is about taking decisions.
Yes.
So how much more relevant does it need to be? This is a core thing, yeah?
I like to clap, but I would not because I would like to do this. This is the best example I have ever got in Mahabharata. Since Vyasa was Pandava Pakshapati, so he has written what happened in the face of saying Pandavas only.
Who was Vyasji is the question we need to ask. How do we come to the inference that he was Pandav Pakshapati? So if somebody has to be Pakshapati, he will be Pakshapati towards people who are his own blood, no? He would have been Pakshapati towards Kauravs, if at all. Because Duryodhan had his blood.
Right.
Yudhishthir didn't. A Rishi is somebody who's a realized person. He will speak the truth. You like it or you don't like it.
You used a word, NiYoga. A lot of people think, what is this having a baby with somebody, man? What is it? Is it not adultery?
Difference between adultery and niyoga, yeah? Adultery is when two individuals, for the sake of pleasure, for the sake of sensual pleasure, only for kaam asakti, get into a relationship.
According to you, how important is this ashram? Why to be in grihastha? I think it's good to be sannyasi. Everybody says, moksha chahiye mujhe. So, why not be sannyasi?
The resource-generating ashram is the grihasthashram. That is why grihasthashram is actually called ashraya sarva ashramanam. Of all the ashramas, this is the ashraya, this is the base.
The best part is, after the beautiful Vishwarupa, 11th chapter, he asked question in 12th chapter. Is he arrogant to ask questions or is it okay to ask questions?
Shishyasteham shadhi mam tvam prapanna. This line is very important. That's when the Gita comes out. When Arjun says, Shishyasteham, I'm your student. Shadhi mam tvam prapanna. Teach me, I surrender to you.
Dharma speaks.